Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Stonekeep. It is late on Sunday night, and I'm without internet, so instead of going on a murdering frenzy and eating my neighbors, I am instead going to record. You'll note that we are at the fountain. I mentioned we were going to get back here. However, instead of wandering us back to the sewers, we're going to do some more stuff on this level first. And I apologize if I sound a little stuffy. My allergies are starting to come in. Anyways, we did find a secret door here, which will make getting around much quicker. Instead of having to go all the way around to get here, now I can just cut through here. And there's that keyhole in the wall down here, which I made note of so that I wouldn't forget. And we're gonna go check that out. Also, I found out this game supports WASD mouse movement instead of having to use the arrow keys, which doesn't sound like anything crazy. But when this game came out, WASD mouse or WASD keyboard movement was not really widely used. So it kinda is a nice convenience feature, and it beats having to have my keyboard slid all the way to the side so that I can move with the arrow keys. Anyways, we have keyhole in wall. Let's see if we have a key for it. Apparently we do.
Mage's study. Do not enter.
Oh yes, that's gonna keep me out. There's a trap! Well, let's see what we got here. Let's see one of these down on it. A couple of these down on it. Get out of there! Oh, come on, I know it's gonna do something. Or maybe it won't. Well now, what the heck kind of trigger is that? Okay. Oh, it's just on a delay or something. Weird. Strange. Okay, let's loot these. Man, game, you are a dick. Where's my bag of rocks? Bag of rocks, bag of rocks. Ah, the bag of rocks. Savior in any dungeon exploration game. From Anvil of Dawn to Dungeon Master, the bag full of rocks is always your savior. Getting a whole bunch of these arrows. Because, I mean, we totally use that bow that we don't have. This is pretty well protected, though. I wonder if it's gonna be worth anything.
If you've come this far, you've come too far. Icarius.
Oh, Icarius. I wonder if I have the key to your study here. I do. Oh, God. Where's the Yoli throwing hatchet? Go! Fixes everything. What in the heck? Well, it's got 25, whatever it is. Let's check our journal. Dwarf sword. A rune wand. Okay. So it's for spell throwing. We got some scrolls. I was about to say, I thought I heard something. Yes. Axe it. Oh God, it's proven impervious to the axe. What about the... Oh. Hammer not so good in the thrown weapon department. Alright, before we start any scroll reading, we're gonna clear this place, make sure there's... Okay, we're good. Let's search this filth on the ground. Nothing. Okay. What do we got?
Addition of the mana circle to my studies. I can proceed with my experiments into the source of magical energies. How do these circles recharge mana? Must research.
Okay.
And use this rune to ignite the fire. Do not point this magic at someone, as it can be very dangerous. Then, take the pot with...
Oh, we got our first rune. I think that's probably like fire.
The use of this rune can help minor wounds of the flesh.
Ooh.
This curing rune does not heal disease or poison, nor can it restore the dead to life. True healers help all, regardless of race or faith.
And we have some healing runes, alright. Wonder if we're gonna get our rune staff in here. Huh?
Send Orson payment for the mana circle.
Okay. Some healing potions. Some stat potions. Some more stat potions. And that's it. And a mana circle. And this. Oh. Yeah, screw whatever that is, mangers. That circle is tempting me, so I'm gonna step in it. Okay, nothing happened. I was hoping we wouldn't get exploded or anything, and we didn't, so that's a win by my standards. As per usual, fuck furniture. I find it endlessly satisfying how Drake can punch a table and it just collapses under the weight of his fists. Okay, let's check runes. Okay, and healing. All right, so we're gonna fuck with this wand, and I'm probably going to end up killing somebody. It's got 25 of whatever that is. Okay. All right, here we go. Do I have to doodle the wand in, or no? Let's see, we gotta go back here, maybe. No. Here. I wonder if I can. No. 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 So can I? Okay, so I can have it up and stab things. Excellent. All right. So we've got it up. Let's figure. Well, that makes my. Okay, there we go. Dang it. There. That's all I want. Now can we zap something? We do have fiery death! Because I'm probably chewing through all of my spell points here. Alright, and there we recharged. Okay, that's good to know. So we have fiery death is confirmed. So it is no longer a question mark. There's an exclamation point! Yay! Okay, and now we have this. Let's see how this works. Ah, dang it. M. Okay. And we can do some minor healing. And something just went up. What just went up? Oh, magic! Oh! Wait, does it still have? Okay, I wonder if. Ah, no, get your staff out. That sounds dirty. I wonder if I can just spam the healing spell. Although it looks like spamming isn't going to be an option because that goes through our spell points pretty quick here. I'm gonna see how much one casting takes. I'm gonna assume it's 5. Okay, so one casting is 2. Dang it. This is gonna take me some getting used to. Yeah, I assume we're not gonna be getting any spell points unless we're actually doing anything. Alright, let's see how much this costs. Alright, that's only 1, so we have fireballs now. Well, minor fireballs. Okay, so we got our magic, and I suppose now we are going to go down. I believe there are higher-end rune staves later in the game that allow you to throw more runes on that time, and I think you actually get to the point where you can combine runes, which will probably result in me making spells that heal enemies and maim my own party members. That's how things seem to roll for me, but I'm sure that will be hilarious when it comes to. Okay, so we want to go north. And we will save before we hit the sewers again, and frustration begins. I hate the sewers. That is one area that I've probably only ever made it past it once or twice ever. It's just easily my least favorite part of the game. Okay. Here's where we're gonna save. Oh, five. I don't know how many save slots we've got. Well, at least eight. I'll probably, like, go to 10 and then loop back. Okay. Let's do this. This place is just so disorienting. Partially due to the walls. And I know there are, like, spikes on the floor at points and stuff. Ah! Big trogs. Of course, they'd have to be big to avoid drowning down here, so. Oh, I think our sword just went up. Come on, Farley. Get working. Yeah, as you can see, if it's on one side of the screen, he can't attack it. To kind of fight with that. That's right, beat on Farley. He's got the hit points for it. You little bastard. Eat my foods. What do we got? Don't care. Aha. Who thought this was a good idea? This is a horrible design. Like, the most obnoxious part is that you can't see the items on the floor. That is the worst part of it. Like, I can understand, like, you know, obscuring spikes and stuff, but items, while realistic, is kind of counterintuitive to a decent play experience. Hey, little bastard, die. Farley, you suck. I don't think you hit it once. Okay, what do we got? Stupid sword, don't care about. Oh, good healing potion. Yeah, nope. You're drinking that. That looks like it. Okay. I have, however, been playing Legend of Grimrock. It is pretty good. It harkens me back to the days of Dungeon Master, which is nostalgic. And no, I won't be LPing it. That game is for me. Oh, I see you around that corner, you little shit. Come at me, goblin bro. I'm going to throw an axe at you as soon as I find it. There it is. Wow. Now I just have to not lose the axe. Oh, come on. Who's cheating? We're supposed to be the ones with numbers on our side. That's one. As you can see, these little shits are pretty beefy now. And that more or less keeps up throughout the entire game. Okay. Use the sword. There's no way. I was gonna say, there's no way that stupid sword is all that's on them. You're kidding me. You're killing me, Smalls. You're killing me. Is there nothing else? Oh, that blows. That fight was nothing but a resource drain. Dang it. And there goes all our healing water. However, we do still have our healing stick. Which, when I was younger, I could never figure out how to get the thing to work because I was stupid. However, now I seem to have figured it out, and I can actually use it to heal myself and pitch fireballs at my. Ooh, I'm gonna throw fireballs at that big throg in the distance back here. After we're done murdering this one. Okay. What do you got? Okay. Seriously, game, you're bending me over here. There's nothing down here either. Okay, let's test out the fiery stick of doom and fire. Where's the fiery stick? There it is. Okay. Drake, you get the fiery stick of doom and fire temporarily. Oh my god, mosquito! Ow! Oh, dead mosquito. Okay. I'm gonna save before we do this in case this thing just comes and is like, well, hello there! And raffle stomps us. Okay, fireball! Pacha! Okay, that worked. Got some litons, and this thing still's got 14 charges of fiery death left in it. As we navigate back to the top of our menu again here. I wonder if that's an area of effect. Because if that's an area of effect, that's actually pretty dang useful. Skull. That's about it. Okay. But what was it guarding? Is the question. It wasn't what it was keeping us away from, it was what it was keeping in, I'm sure. I'm just waiting, because I know what the thing is. I know I saw a hand there. Oh, bull. That's such horse crap. I was like, yeah, it's that crank that we need. No. I don't think it's a crank that
there is something odd about this wall. I believe there is a mechanism for sliding it to the right. But I don't see the controls here. How can you tell that? Looks like a normal wall to me. Keen dwarven senses, my friend. Keen dwarven senses.
Okay. So, a mechanism on this wall, huh? And there's nothing. However, I'll pull up our map. I'm gonna make note of that. And okay. Gonna pull back here. Oh god! Farley took a swipe as he was moving past. Little bastard. Quit trying to get out of Farley's area of effect. We call that the Dwarven Kill Zone. Gotta take a swing at it. Even though I'm fairly certain he can't hurt them with his bare hands. Here you go, Drake. God, you are a... I've heard cows eat more quietly than he eats. Okay. I'm gonna make sure there's nothing in this alcove. Go over it one more time. Okay. Yes, I'm paranoid. Give me a break. No. I just saw a hand, I think. At some point in there. Where was it? Am I just imagining things? Possibly. I don't know.
Ow, my foot!
Yeah, that would be the spikes. Yeah. Oh, that wasn't the spikes. That's one of the things we need. I don't know if we'll be able to drain the fluid with just one of them. I think we might need two. Oh, dang it. Okay, we will head over here. I'm surprised it's actually been such a straight, you know, shot thus far. I remember this place being a bit mazier than this. But maybe that's just because I was young. Yeah, okay, I guess that's it. I guess we're gonna go back and plug this thing in, and then we should be able to access the deeper areas past that door. I think there's like a lever on the floor or something. You hear it, folks? Do you hear it screeching in the dark? It's waiting for us. Map time. We should be almost out. Yes. I hate this level so much. And we'll also be up here so we can hit the healing too, because we'll be out near it. Okay, and I think we want to go this way if I recall correctly. Really wish they'd... Oh, you can skip through them pretty quick. That's good to know. Alright, and we want to go down and then left. Ba-doof! And we want to go this way. And go through one of these walls. Oh no, it's further down, isn't it? Yeah, it's past these doors. Nope. Map time, because I'm confused. Okay, and of course we're standing right next to him. And now we lap up water. Yay, healing water! And we'll fill our water skin. Okay, let's go diddle around with stuff here real quick. Try this one first because it's adjacent. Well, it's the first one anyways. Alright, where is this thing? Okay. And this, of course, we can't do anything with. Can I pull it out now is the question. No, and it's locked in. Alright. We'll go down again and see if that did what we needed it to do. Because it sure as hell ain't telling us. Like, I heard mechanisms crunching under the ground beneath our feet. Thank you, Farley, that's most helpful. I know! But no, we can't have that. King Dwarven senses only work some of the time. This is that damn mage's... No, this is where we want to go. I'm learning. I only need the map 90% of the time now. First, we will check to see if anything happened on the map where we can notice it. Yes, the wall is gone there. Alright, I think this will be where we bump into either snakes or the monster, which I think it's the monster we'll be bumping into, and at this point I believe we'll just see it like a tentacle, which I will be probably screeching in fear of, and that's the monster that I'll be using my circle spinny screwing with their AI technique, because I don't recall whether or not you can actually kill the thing. Okay, we're a ways away yet. You hear it. It freaks me out, man. Dang it. Wrong turn. Let me go this way. Right and left. And it's straight ahead. And as you can see, I'm a wall, which means save game. Okay. Journal, go! Make sure we are where we want to be. We are. Okay. Nothing here. Nothing on the ground. Just was that something on the ground there? Nope, just me seeing things. Freaking out, man! Mm. No, I'm not. Just kind of taking my time here because I know it's around here and I'd really rather not bump into it. Totally not doing that. Check and see if there's anything. Nope, nothing in the alcove. Oh, there it is. Okay. The tentacle beast! Which I don't recall whether or not. Oh, yes, we can hurt it. And here's where we do our spinny trick of doom. Because otherwise, it's, as you can see, it's hit Drake twice and has him down to half health. Yeah. Inventory. No, don't throw a firebomb. Which one of you fools did that? You dingbats. Although that is a good idea. Farley, if you threw a firebomb, I commend you. But don't do it again. Unless they're like your own personal stash. Man, how do I get back into somewhere? Inventory. Firebomb. Go! Inventory. Firebomb. Go! Inventory. Where's the fire stick? Fire stick, fire stick, fire stick, fire stick! I'm gonna throw this into his main hand so he can keep that shield up. Trey Drake, level that magic. Honestly, like I said, I do not recall whether or not you can actually kill this stupid thing. Okay, what else do we have? They're pitching darts and stuff at it, but I'm gonna lose them. So we're gonna try fighting. Back to the spinny technique. As Drake gets ripped apart. I mean, we're clearly making it bleed. Whether or not we're capable of killing it, however, I guess is as good as mine. Oh, we've got it down to two tentacles. So that means it's at least to 2/3 health. Yay! I really shouldn't be wasting these when I have that wineskin full of healing water. Forethought, it escapes me sometimes. Get out of here, you gigantic tentacle bastard! Oh, that's another one. And the last one. Okay! We've killed it. Oh, now it's under the water attacking us, and now we can't hurt it. Yeah, this part, I do recall not being able to hurt the thing. Okay, journal time. Journal! Okay. Map, map, map. Now, while we were coming in here, I thought I saw my hand move over something, like we could pick something. Aha! What is that? Come at me, underwater thing, bro. There's something ahead here. Oh, bullshit. Fucking skulls. The good thing is, however, since it's under the water, it actually can't impede us. So long as we keep moving, I don't believe it can really do too much to us, aside from make the camera twig out like it does. And I think to kill this thing, we end up like sucking it down a drain pipe or something. No. I'm looting game. Quit it. No. Dang it. Inventory. Damn it. Inventory. I'm frustrating myself here. Okay. Inventory. There we go. Because we can look for stuff without it bugging us when we're in the inventory. There's something there. I have a feeling it's probably another skull, and I'm just overworking myself a little bit. But we're gonna heal here. And actually, I'm going to save it and call it an episode. I'm gonna save this in a second slot. And we will continue next time, wherein I will probably continue running in circles trying to figure out what's on the ground. However, I'm going to squeak my chair loudly in the background there, and we're going to call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time.